time this meeting gets out of hand, we're going to close the meeting, adjourn it, and that's it. Final say, because this is a township meeting. I know you guys all have opinions and questions for us, but if it's going to get out of hand, we're just going to adjourn the meeting, and then we'll start again next month. This time, we're going to call the June 15th, 2016, Milford Township to order. We're going to start it off with the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Start with the roll call, please.
Don?
Yeah.
Jack?
Yes.
Scott?
That's okay.
Take a look at the minutes from last meeting. See if there's any corrections, omissions. Motion we accept the minutes from last month.
I second.
Things first, regular township business, and we'll get to the other stuff. We tabled bids last month for garage renovations. We're still waiting for engineer plans from Fox Engineering, so we'll reopen bids for the garage next month. Put out bids for 2 miles of used guardrail. We received one bid from Shimon Supply. There's like 8 areas that we have went out to bid. And the total for the whole thing is $24,320. Pentagon Gas, we have a status update as of today, June 15th, 2016, for the proposed project on 492. The spokesperson stated property has been officially purchased and the company is enthusiastic about the project being built. The currently waiting on some permits from the state of Connecticut in regards to transport. Once they have initial, they will proceed with permitting process here within the township. Yes, I am, I forgot. Kenny?
Yep.
Kenny, you got any things since I missed you last time? We'll put you in here right now.
Today I had an informational tour along with County Emergency Management of CDC2, which is the East Lake Road Complete Station. Just an informational tour to keep people who are in emergency management up to date on exactly what they're building and their procedures up there and to make us familiar with the facility. Very good, very informational.
CDP2, Ken?
Yes.
That was with the county, you said?
The county EMA and DT took us through the facility.
That's it, since I mentioned last month?
Unless it's a regional training thing, which are ongoing.
Okay, all right, Ken, thank you.
Can you say who Ken is?
Ken Bondra, sorry, he's our emergency management coordinator. We missed him last month because everybody wanted to talk about the incinerator.
So how do you spell his last name, Ken what?
B-O-N-D-U-R-A-N-T, Kenny?
So he had a meeting, informational tour with EMA from the county?
Yep.
And that was concerning the Pentagon gas site?
No.
That was concerning
CD2, compressor station.
CDP, which one?
On East Lake Road.
East Lake Road.
The East Lake one, Road one?
CD2.
CDP2?
Yes.
I think it's CDP or something they say, CDP2. East Lake.
Start with this. All right, this is what we know on the incinerator. Partner within Tyler's Corner Group reached out to the township today, June 15th, and offered the following information. Tyler Corners Group had a luncheon with Commissioner Alan Hall, Planning Director Bob Templeton, as well as others to discuss the informal plans and associated economic benefits. They have not, I repeat, not had any further correspondence with said groups of participants since. Dates and times are not given. Tyler's Corner Group met with two representatives from DEP for an informal information session. They did not, I repeat, not participate in a pre-application meeting, which is part of the formal application process, nor have they submitted any formal plans or permit applications to DEP. They have not, I repeat, not had any further correspondence with DEP. Information regarding this matter was verified by a supervisor in the Waste Management Department at DEP. Dates and times were not given. Tyler Corners Group is currently waiting on title clearance for the proposed site. This is anticipated to clear on or before June 25th of 2016. Tyler's Corner Group does not currently have formal or engineered plans for said site and or facility and will not pursue the preparation of plans until the title has cleared. Mike Gaffery, legal representative for Tyler's Corner Group, will be sending a letter of intent with regards to the project to the township supervisors within the next few business days. Tyler's Corner Group anticipates they will be prepared to make full disclosure of the project in its entirety within 60 to 90 days. At that time, they will schedule the following: a public workshop locally for those wishing to attend, and an appearance at a regularly scheduled township meeting. They will also launch a website at this time containing additional information as well as a question and answer session. A direct phone line will also open for public access. Tyler Group wants a couple other additional items the public to be aware of at this time. They plan to develop all of said property, bringing in gas, electric, sewer, wastewater treatment facility, and all necessary utilities and the like.
A quick question, what's the acreage involved?
I'm not sure. Let's see. All necessary utilities and the like to provide a sound infrastructure for a modern, well-maintained industrial park. Other types of business to be included in the development aside from an incinerator have not yet been discussed. With regards to the incinerator itself, at full capacity, it will provide 100% full-time job opportunities. It will follow regulations and the process involved as set forth by the EPA and DEP. A state-of-the-art monitoring system will be built right into the facility itself, and the air quality will be tested on a regular basis. Tyler Corners Group said they wish to be a good corporate neighbor. They plan to provide a full disclosure at all times. They will follow all federal, state, and county laws and regulations, and they look forward to the opportunity to introduce themselves to our community. Vera, do you have a question?
Yes, I have questions and comments from based on what you just read.
One moment. 2 minutes, that's the limit.
Okay.
Please be quiet while everybody else is asking their questions so we can hear them and not be rude.
Okay, so you're keeping time? Somebody's keeping time?
Yes, we are.
Yes.
Okay. My question is, one of the questions, you said Tyler Group reached out to the township today. That means this is the first time they've reached out to you? Is that correct?
Yes.
And it says that Tyler is a partner within the group. And does this person identify themselves? And why can't we have a name and identification?
They identify themselves as part owner, as a partner, and their first name is Tom.
Tom, so why can't we have a full name?
He didn't give me a full name.
And I want to say also, no dates and times are given, and why not? They can't give you dates and times. When did they last speak to DEP?
They didn't say. The conversation was very brief, and I didn't ask what the date and time was they spoke to them.
So you can get that information for us next time? Actually speak to DEP?
When I hung up the phone with them, I phoned DEP immediately.
And you spoke to somebody?
Yes, a supervisor in waste management.
And do you have
Tracy,
a name?
Tracy.
Tracy who?
No last name.
You need to get last names, please, so we can verify. You can't just get first names. Full names are important. So we have Tracy at this, and this is in waste management?
She's supervisor of the waste management department at DEP.
At DEP, mm-hmm. Supervisor? And then you said there's a title clearance being waited for. That means, are they saying they're in contract for sale, which is contract for purchase? There's a purchase agreement? So that's why they're now waiting for title clearance. And they're saying, I would like to also know, the only thing you can approve as township is what? The driveway permit for this facility, for this site?
If it's on a state road, we can't even approve that.
So is it on a state road?
I don't know. I haven't seen any plans. I don't know where the driveway is going.
So if it's on a state road, PennDOT has to approve the driveway permit. If it's on a township road, you have to approve it. And is there anything else you have to approve as a township? Do you have to approve the sewage?
We have a say in the sewage.
You have a say?
Yep.
So if it's on a township road, can you also say no? Do you ever say no to a permit?
Sure.
You can say no?
Yes.
And, okay, and then?
2 minutes are up, so quick, this is it.
And I understand it's about 100 acres. That's what I've heard, and I've investigated. I spoke to the listing agent, so it's about 100 acres that they're willing to develop. Thank you.
Willing to develop.
Susan Oakley?
I'd like to defer my time to Mike back there.
I'm already on this, so.
You have extra. Yeah, but I want you to have my time, too.
I'll go.
Give mine
Yeah, my half 14.
It looks like, well, you can tell us when we get to you, because we don't know who you are, so hang on just a second.
Glenn Schreffler?
Yes. I'd like to ask you if New Milford has any zoning restrictions.
No.
None whatsoever.
Why not?
Yeah, why not?
Because we brought it up 12, 13 years ago, and there was 300 people in this place. Did not want it.
That's not wrong.
I never said it was wrong.
No, it's not forever. I mean, things change, times change.
Yep. So. Ron Stroll?
Yes, first question. Was anybody from this board at the meeting last night?
No, I wasn't. I had prior commitments.
Yeah. Anybody?
Prior commitments?
That time has passed.
You were right.
I was not.
You were not. Okay.
So this adversely affects your constituents and yourself. Nobody was there.
Our emergency manager.
That would be Ken Bondurant.
Ken Bondurant.
Bondurant.
I'll try and talk fast. We listened to a very good waltz last night and couldn't get an answer to this question. So we'll bring it up again. If this comes before you as a final plan, will you approve it or deny it? We already know that it affects your constituents adversely.
Without seeing the
plans, we have to answer. Yeah, I can't really give you an answer. I need to find out more information, just like you guys are. Do I want an incinerator in my backyard? Not particularly.
It's not just an incinerator.
I realize
it's an industrial hazardous waste incinerator.
I realize that.
Okay, I'll move on. Pretty much, Alan.
Please
Ball,
do not speak when someone else is speaking. I have to be able to take minutes. You cannot talk.
Pretty much Alan Hall put this all in your laps last night. Just wondered if you had a reaction on that.
The township has no zoning. Our zoning...
I'm not addressing zoning.
Let me finish. All our stance, where we stand right now, falls on the county level. So what we know for so far, and what Alan's saying is, we're going back and forth saying, he said, we said. So we're taking what he's saying, he's taking what we're saying, and we're just kind of keeping it all written down and keeping track. So we know what he's saying.
I mean, so that leaves us pretty much in the dark.
I know. Well, we're trying to get answers just like you are.
Well, I just wanted to make you aware that if you weren't at the meeting, you threw you under the bus last
night. I talked to numerous people who were at the meeting, and they filled me in.
What procedures do we have to go through to pass ordinances? Is there a written procedure in your infrastructure?
It has to go through the solicitor. It has to be advertised so many times in the paper, so many days apart,
okay. And
then it has to be voted on as to whether or not it's going to be accepted.
So the procedure to...
The procedure itself is actually fairly simple, as long as the solicitor approves all the legal language within the ordinance.
What percentage of the occupants of the borough need to sign that to have it presented?
Township.
I don't think that we need any percentage. We just need something presented to have legal representation look over.
And then who votes on it? When you say vote, who votes?
Board of Supervisors.
Okay, just one last thing. Going back to how this adversely affects us. They say that there will be modern, built-in monitoring systems, which of course is required. They're not doing anything extraordinary. But currently, there is no monitoring system, federal, state, or local, that monitors nanoparticles that are going to be released by this, just so you know that up front. And if I have any seconds left, I defer them to you.
Say that again?
There's no monitoring system that will pick up any nanoparticles that are released. and they're released by the hundreds of millions. And they're all toxic, including heavy metal.
And cancer.
Thank you.
Not sure. Pat Burton?
Yeah.
Burton, did I say that right?
Yeah. My question is about the building ordinance, like a building permit. I want to know how we could go about for a building permit, because you got to have a permit for every building. And so what do we have to do as a community to stop it? And I'm going to defer my time to Mike, right? Thank you.
I think that's building permit. I mean, we have our small permit for a building, but I think that building all falls under commercial, which is labor industry, which is, I think that's C. Now, our inspector does some of it, but I think there's somebody else. State comes in to do that too, so.
Is it under?
We can ask that question to our.
Yeah, we can ask our building inspector how that, I'm not sure exactly how it works, but for a commercial, it's different than like residential.
Okay, can you give me the information when you get that?
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I had it written down.
Okay, Mike, rest of my time, you're back to Mike.
Would it fall under the planning commission at all, the building permit?
No.
No? That's just the land ordinance?
Can you do something? There's only one of you can do something.
I think
we're going to have to try to do something with them or make them, you know, work together because, well, turn around.
It's going to be proactive.
Quite a few people in here aren't too thrilled about it, so.
Absolutely, and you're elected to stay with the board. And this gentleman also over here said, whenever, are you going to approve or disapprove some sort of plans? And your comment back, if I remember right now, was, I got to see it and all that, but my point is, do you have the authority to disapprove or approve that? It doesn't sound like it.
We have some.
I don't know, to be honest with you. That's something that Mike Gribble would have to answer. I don't know if you do.
I know.
Well, according to Mr. Hall last night.
One person, please.
Pardon me.
So the answer to that is maybe you have some, but then again, maybe not enough disclosure, if that's our intent.
We keep having stuff like this, we'll have to figure it.
Exactly. Now, the other thing I've got is, Mike, everybody's referring to Mike Ewall. And he's here and he's going to speak. At last night's meeting, and this is just really a question for you, it seems like the way to approach this from what he said, and he kind of seems to be our expert right now, is by way of ordinance. Zoning isn't going to take care of it. Anything else isn't going to take care of it. We've got to draw up an ordinance that makes it so tough for them that it's expensive for them, and they're irritated by it a whole bit, and they'll go elsewhere. That's the way you laid it out last night. So you talked also that maybe you're going to have an ordinance written up for this tonight. You're going to address all of it. That's what I knew. That seems to be, with everything else that's being said, the ordinance seems to be what, with his experience and your expertise, the thing to do. And that's where we're going to put our effort.
Yes. Excellent.
Felicia Murray?
That's me. I don't care. I looked up on the computer the definition of township supervisors is determine the budget, enact ordinances, and levy taxes, employ workers, enforce ordinances, and approve expenditures, oversee the police, local roads, zoning, building permits, and taxes. I don't understand why you just told us that something might be happening the 26th of this month, which is not that far away, why we haven't been on this already with ordinances.
It's never happened before.
But the knowledge of it was out there. It already went around the town, and then for a while it stopped. I didn't see anything because I was completely on Facebook, following everything on Facebook, trying to get the whole town involved in this whole thing.
I'm not on Facebook, so.
Well, a lot of people are, and I think that's our fastest way in this old town to get things situated and started. But we don't understand as a town why this hasn't been looked at in the ordinances. If this is the only thing that's going to stop this company, then why haven't we started it? I don't understand that.
Because we've been checking into trying to get as much information as we can and see what the best route possible to tackle this.
Okay, as far as Mr. Allen Hall, I think a lot of people on my side know that he's kind of a crooked commissioner. The way he talked last night, the things he said in the past are all coming to seeing that he is not a representative of our county or the people that live in New Milford. So we shouldn't deal with him at all. We should deal with you guys.
Community, why would you even entertain this type of business for our community when you also have family and property value? This is just asinine as far as I'm concerned. It just doesn't make any sense. Why would you even entertain it? Also, if you're going to pass some kind of an ordinance, it's either zero tolerance or nil tolerance so that they cannot even qualify for matching that ordinance. I'm living with that pumping station on East Lake Road, I went through hell for a year listening to that 24/7. Finally got them to put covers over their fans, six of them. And there were no ordinances, none whatsoever. You're not helping the community out at all sitting there.
Yes, we are.
No, not you. Them.
Yes.
Thank you.
And you're wrong about the ordinance on the noise. There is ordinances on the noise, and the whole thing is done through the county.
So why did it take a year for them to comply?
They actually, can I answer that?
Yeah.
They actually don't have to comply. They did it as a favor. They were already within.
I was on their ass for a year.
I know you were, because they were on mine. They didn't have to put those on those fans. They were already within the ordinance of the county. And any ordinance the county has would supersede ours. So they, that's
so,
true.
So you're saying that any ordinance you pass now is going to be superseded by the county's ordinance?
It could be. If they put something out there, it'll supersede us.
The other way, I
think. No, it's not.
Right.
So it goes uphill.
So why
counties
is Alan,
above local, then state, then federal.
So
that's
why is Alan Hall saying it's up to you to pass an ordinance?
We don't know why he's saying that.
So what do we need you for if we just go directly to the county? Well, I'd like an answer, please.
Say that again?
I said, why do we need you if everything is superseded in ordinances by the county?
Not all the county's ordinances are superseded.
Oh, but just certain ones? Which ones? Would you be able to explain that to me, please?
I'm really not sure.
So you really don't know what you're doing, then?
Apparently not.
I didn't appreciate the sarcastic comment.
I don't appreciate getting grilled. I'm trying to do the best I can with what I know.
Believe me, you said right up front, we live here too. We got kids, we got grandkids.
And you
we
want this here?
No, we did not bring this here.
No, you don't want this here?
What? I don't even know what it is yet.
Yes, you do. We certainly know what it is.
Do you know what type of incinerator it is? Because we don't.
It's a hazardous waste incinerator.
They told us it was not hazardous.
Yeah, well, that's not what Mike says.
But how does he know that? Is he part of the group? Is he a partner in the group? Is he an owner in the group? We don't know.
We'll have to let Mike talk about
it. We'll have to let the group sit in the group.
Okay.
So is the group saying it's only an industrial incinerator, not a hazardous one?
Yeah.
Is that what Tyler is saying to you?
Industrial.
Mr. Hall said last night.
Mr. Hall said that last night?
He said it was last night, that it was hazardous waste.
And that might be what he said to you, but I can only go by the phone call I took today from the group itself, and that's not what they said to us. So you have to understand, we're giving you the information we have.
So Tom, the part owner, said it's an industrial incinerator.
That is exactly how he referred to it.
That's how he referred to it?
That's correct.
He's deferring his time.
Mindy.
Elliot Ross.
I just want to read a brief statement if I can. And I wasn't aware it was going to be 2 minutes, so I apologize. I'll try to read it quickly. My name's Elliot Ross. I live in Herrick Township, which is located approximately 12 air miles from the proposed site of the alleged incinerator under consideration. I'm a farmer raising beef cattle and also the owner of an inn and restaurant, both businesses operating in Herrick Township. I trace my roots to an early settler of Clifford Township, namely Captain Jonathan Burns, my great-great-great-grandfather, who arrived in the 1802 several years before Susquehanna County officially existed. Through the past two centuries, my relatives have always maintained a connection to Susquehanna County, and I've always felt a certain appeal to this area as well. While I'm not a native in the true sense of the word, following the completion of my education in 1972, I chose to make this my permanent residence. And I've lived here ever since in a home which previously belonged to my grandparents. I have a daughter who also loves this area, and I hope she will succeed me in the ownership of this home when I have passed on. The reason for my attendance this evening is to formally request of your board the opportunity for my daughter and sons and daughters of all citizens of areas located in the impact area of this proposed incinerator to maintain their rights as mandated in the Pennsylvania Constitution, that of clean air. It is within your power to adopt regulations that could help prevent this facility from becoming a nightmare that other communities across the nation have come to know. Furthermore, among Susquehanna County's numerous attributes, clean air and water, and the high quality of our natural environment, they help to attract significant tourist dollars to our area. It's not hard to imagine the adverse impact this proposal would have on the tourist industry, one to which our county has so diligently and determinedly promoted and pursued over the past 20 to 30 years, an industry which, by the way, employs directly or indirectly hundreds and perhaps thousands of local individuals. Additionally, relying on the DEP or the EPA to defend us from the ill effects of this proposal is a false hope. I respect both organizations and admire their attempts to protect our environment, but they are underfunded, understaffed, and generally not timely or entirely effective. Finally, this is an engineering proposal which, like all man-made ventures, has a shelf life. It's unrealistic to assume that this facility will operate as advertised on day one, let alone years into its lifespan. To conclude, I would state that ignoring the opportunity to confront this proposal head-on is, simply put, a disservice to your own community and a slap in the face to those of us who lack the authority yet happen to live downwind. I'm a supervisor in Herrick Township, and if I were in your position, I would be quick to adopt an ordinance that would provide the area's residents with reasonable safeguards from the hazards this facility is likely to generate. You have the power to do the right thing, and I graciously ask that you do so. Your legacy stands in the balance. Thank you for your consideration, Elliot Bronson.
Thank you. Kathy Noble?
Yes, I would like to know why this has been so secretive. We had to hear it through word of mouth, and nothing was said about it at all since October of 15 when this land was being purchased. I would like to know why we wasn't told anything about it. And the news last night, Channel 16, is the only one that said that we're going to get this industry. I would like to know why you guys know about it, but you don't tell nobody.
We really didn't know about it till
yes, late.
Okay, we did then. I got no answer for you. Joe Roberts?
I defer my time. My question was already answered.
Tony Barron?
Barone.
Barone.
I'm a township resident, live on Sutton Road. Moved up here 11 years ago. Happy to get out of New Jersey. Came here because it reminded me of my boyhood home in Berkshire Hills in Massachusetts. Clean air, just a nice place to live. Moved up here, it was like moving into heaven. Since then, some of the nice things that I liked about this county have been sort of gone away. I like the peace and quiet. Now we have a compressor station, so that's sort of important. We had clear skies, you see. And now there's lights and flying J, compressor stations, and such. That's distorted. But we still have lichen growing on the barks of trees. That's indicative of very clean air. I hope that that is important. We love our democracy. I've always maintained there's a real problem in democracy. That it's hard to be a good citizen, and we have to rely on representatives. And we're going to trust you to do the right thing, and I hope the trust is in this place.
Thank you.
Well,
I live in the borough. My parents and my grandmother live in the township. I think it's a few things come to mind. First of all, it's easy to attack these three guys, two guys and one woman sitting in front of us. However, they do put their necks out there trying to, keep this town running. And I've seen these guys out there working. I apologize, I can't recall your name. He's always out there with a shovel. He's working hard. He's doing, keeping stuff moving. I wrote my master's thesis on the natural gas industry. I wrote my thesis on the effects of a boom cycle and a bust cycle and how it was going to affect Susquehanna County. I wrote about the housing market, and I think our community's done a good job building housing for senior citizens so that they can have somewhere to go, so that guys that are young and trying to get moving, that they can buy a house or they can rent a house, and so that the market value isn't affected. With the interjection of the natural gas energy industry, it's changed our community tremendously. Now, what two things come to mind? Number one, we're not hurting right now. We actually have a grand opportunity. And I'm not saying that we should do an incinerator, but what I'm saying is we have abundant natural gas. We produce it from our shale and our geology here. If we needed so badly money, if we needed so badly to make our economy move forward, we could seek out manufacturing. We could bring in who we want. Excuse me, I don't let my friends pick me. I pick my friends. I don't let the people that hang around my life choose me. I choose the people I want to be inside my circle. We as a community have the opportunity and the gift to choose who we bring into our community. And I don't think it's really that hard to determine that an incinerator is not a good opportunity for us. With that said, I also, in growing up, always knew if mom made the decision or if dad made the decision. Does the township make the decision or does the county? Because if dad said, hey, don't do that, I didn't do it. And if mom said, don't do that, it's my decision, I didn't do it. Because otherwise I got slapped upside the head. Now, we need to not only know, but we also need to be very clear, just like we talked about. If it is our right and our decision to draft ordinances, the man sitting in front in the white, she made the comment, if that's the case, we need to be actively pursuing that. We should be doing that. So, who's in charge, and whoever is in charge, we got to get our legality straight, and let's bring in the right person for the county. We want to generate income. We want to generate economy. We can do that very intelligently. We can utilize our clean burning natural gas here, but we don't need to bring in pollution. And I don't care what Alan Hall says. You can't get clean steam out of burnt paint and narcotics. And with that, also, just to end, I'm busy working hard, trying to generate a positive impact in my community, supply quality service to my community. Those of you who know me know what I do. I own a business in the community. I'm going to just offer again, just like the gentleman said, we trust you three in front of us. You have my respect for the hard work that you put in. We can see the emotions that you're under right now. I want everyone in this room to understand we're facing them and they're facing us, and in the middle there's a line. That's symbolic. That's not how it actually is. We are all together here.
That's right.
They are on the same team as we are. Yes. But we are on the same team. Now, again, with that said, I'm a man of clear expectation. With that said, it's our expectation that you represent us as constituents, and that we know who's in charge, and that we draw that line, and that line is hard, fast, and put there to be serious. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Joe. I mean, we agree with you, you know. I mean, you guys know more than we know, but we're trying to get caught up like you are. I said, we're not trying to hide anything. We're learning as we go on this. We're trying to find out as much information as we can to cover our ass so we don't have all these people in the township meetings.
We can draw.
I mean, it's good, and we're trying to, you know, it's good to get all this feedback. For the last 8 months, there's been two people here, so.
We want to hear that you're on our side.
That's what we want to hear.
There's no way.
We never said we're on.
Let's work together. Work together.
We're trying.
That's how you work.
We can bring in the people that we want. If we want to create jobs, we can bring those people in. A manufacturer that is high on energy, someone that's going to need high amounts of energy, let's bring them in here. Someone who's not going to produce high amounts of pollution, but that's going to consume high amounts of energy, that's going to produce jobs. That's a perfect situation for what we're in right now.
Recycling.
Good one, and there are alternatives for whatever they might want to try to put into the incinerator. Now, one of the things I did look at, we researched it yesterday and looked at the latest information from EPA on hazardous waste incinerators, if that's what we're talking about, and the types of things like pharmaceutical waste and paints and whatnot. It sounds like they are describing a hazardous waste incinerator, so that may be the more likely thing that's proposed, but we can't know for sure. But we looked at that, then the 10 operating facilities around the country, we found that the amount of pollution coming out by accident, what they call fugitive emissions, things from just leaky pipes, explosions, things that get out that aren't supposed to, were the same level as the pollution coming out of the stack that's supposed to be coming out. It was almost the same exact number if you look at the totals for the whole country across those incinerators, and that shocked me. I mean, you're used to seeing some level of accidents, but in this industry it's endemic, to the point where it equals what would be coming out of the stack if they're operating normally. Now, one of the things I talked about last night is the need for continuous emissions monitoring, and this gets to one of the things that you can and are empowered to do with an air ordinance. Anything with a smokestack, whatever type of incinerator they're talking about, is going to be required to monitor about 3 pollutants on a continuous basis: carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, and sulfur dioxide. A few other things that aren't pollutants, and everything else, they'll test 1 day a year or not at all. That's typical for all sorts of permits, for whether you're burning coal, gas, trash, sewage sludge, any of those things. Those permits almost look identical in terms of what they require to them to be known on a day-to-day basis. And the reason that's unacceptable is that we have the technology to do a lot better. When we're talking about the toxins like mercury, like dioxins, like even the particulate matter, the soot that gets into the lung, causes strokes and heart attacks, those things can be monitored on a continuous basis, but when they look 1 day a year, it's kind of like letting drivers drive around with no odometer on the highway and setting a speed trap 1 day a year where you say, watch out, speed trap ahead, you have all these signs. And then the brother of the driver is running the speed trap because the company's hired their own consultants to do the testing. That's how things with smokestacks are actually monitored for most pollutants and for all the things that are toxic. And that's unacceptable because we know they're speeding many other days of the year because these are best behavior tests. They know they're coming up. They don't test when they're starting up, shutting down, or having malfunctions when we know the emissions are highest. And so you have the power to pass a requirement that'll make any type of incinerator have to continuously monitor these pollutants, report the data to a website for the whole community to see, and you can also set stricter standards so they have to be the cleanest they could possibly be. And you do that, and any company I've seen before will choose not to comply with it and go somewhere else because they know that they don't want that level of accountability, even though the technology exists to do that. Now, incinerators are incredibly unpopular. Wherever you go, it's almost impossible to build one. People rise up. It's happened several times in Pennsylvania. Rural communities get targeted with these. Some of them have fought for over a decade to stop them. One of the most key things that causes elected officials, and I don't mean as a threat in any way, but causes elected officials to no longer be elected officials, is permitting incinerators to be built. because people get organized like this and realize that if they do whatever they have to protect their community, if that means running for office, that tends to happen. Now, I've seen businesses come out opposed to this. In Erie, Pennsylvania, we helped a community group organize when they wanted to build the largest tire incinerator in the world. And next to it, they were going to create 80 jobs at that incinerator. Next to it was a meatpacking plant that has 250 jobs. And after that company learned about it, they said, we're shutting down and moving if that thing's built. Net loss of jobs if you had that. And that was just from the one business. Other businesses also lined up after that and said, we're not standing for this either. And that's happened in a number of places. So it's not just individual people, but we can be looking at losses of businesses here if something of this scale comes in. Now on the nanoparticles point, Hugh and others brought up, nanoparticles cannot be detected or stopped by filters. So you can't regulate that in an ordinance because the technology doesn't even exist. The only way you can protect yourself from that is not let this come here in the first place. But you can set standards that are strict for other things that technology does exist for and make sure that you're not likely to have a company come here with this kind of proposal. So let me speak quickly to the authority you do have. Now, the federal law says that states and local governments, this is the Federal Clean Air Act, can have stricter air pollution laws than federal law. The state has an Air Pollution Control Act that flows from that because of that federal designation of power. And the state law says that local governments can be stricter than state or federal law. So it's very explicit. If you want to write it down, you can write down the citations, 35 PS 4012 and then a little A. That's the authority that says that you can do what I'm talking to you about right now. You also have an obligation to do this. Under the second class township code, you have the obligation to protect the health, safety, and welfare of your residents. But you also have in the Pennsylvania Constitution, Article 1, Section 27, that the people in the state have the right to clean air. And you, as public officials, even local public officials, have a duty, a trustee's duty, to protect that right. So I've already drafted an ordinance for you. Drafted it earlier today. There are some things that I might want to come back to and tweak in terms of the numbers to make sure they're as protective as they can be in terms of how much pollution would be allowed. So we set a standard that a company would have to be the most angelic incinerator ever to do, and they're probably not going to do that because even other ones don't tend to follow the permits that they are already given by the states and federal government. You don't need zoning to do this. Zoning is actually something I wouldn't even recommend for this, because with zoning you have grandfathering and you have other things where companies are used to challenging it, where they can come in and say, well, you have to invest somewhere, so if not here, then somewhere else, and they can sue you and they can win more easily. But with air, there is no grandfathering, and you have a lot more power and rights to come up with your own rules than if you played in a zoning sandbox, so to speak. The best time to act is still now, though. Before you have a proposal and move very far, before you have a company invest a lot of money and resources into this, act now, and you won't necessarily have a 10-year battle on your hands like Allenwood had, like Clary in Pennsylvania had. They took a lot of years to defeat those. Final couple points. Someone says something about the county superseding things. The county cannot supersede this. The county can pass its own air ordinance if it really wanted to, but you can still have a stricter one. But they can't set something that takes away your right to do one. I've never seen that happen. I'd be shocked if they tried, and I don't think it would hold up in court if they did try. And finally, I'll say one good thing about Alan Hall. I don't know him very well. I know folks aren't very happy with him, but he did say one thing last night that did make sense. He also said something that was completely factually wrong, that the county doesn't have the power to do this, and that's very clear in the part of the state law that gives you the power. It gives counties the power too. So he's wrong on that, but he was right when he said that the lowest level of government is the highest in Pennsylvania. You do have more powers, not in terms of air pollution, you have the same powers, but in a lot of other ways, you have more powers than the county. The county is not going to supersede you, and you not only have the power, but you have the duty and obligation, and you have the residents who really want you to do this. So I'm thankful for the time that you've given me and that you're here. I'm happy to answer questions and stick around as long as you like, and I'll make my information available.
I know we need an ordinance. We need a clean air ordinance, I know. How quickly can we get it in? And do we as a public here can vote it in right now so they can get ahead and start putting it in? In other words, do we have to vote it in and we have to say, yeah,
we can't do it right now, so we'll have to advertise it. So it'll take at least one, maybe two meetings. do that, just based on your processes?
Do you have an ordinance within that we can get to our solicitor?
Yes, I can email it to you right after the meeting.
Okay.
So in other words, we have to keep coming, people have to know that this is not over, that they have to keep coming, watch the newspapers, watch the ads and the Mullican will be putting in there, just to know what's going on, and there should be a website open, but besides that, since we appreciate what he's doing, is there any money in the budget so we can help this young man out? Is there any general fund in your budget, in your township budget, to help this young man out? Because he deserves it.
I'm gonna address three different things. The first one is by an environmental group, because I'm kind of curious, are you an attorney that would come in with an ordinance? You're coming in with all these facts and figures based on a potential for an incinerator that we're not really sure what we're going to burn. You certainly got everybody excited, 70 people that I've counted. So I'm kind of curious, what degree do you have and who finances you? We shouldn't have to pony up money if you're financed by Penvest or River Keepers.
Cindy, I'm going to interrupt you for a moment. I'm going to answer.
Sorry,
I'm
going
to speak to three things real quick first. First, you cited the 35 PS 4012, I already did my own research, have it. We already have turned it over to the solicitor.
Oh, that's off my list.
Thank you.
I wanted to ask you to clarify, are you saying there's only 10 incinerators nationwide?
There are only 10 commercial hazardous waste incinerators.
There's 22. I have the research right here. There's 22 with phone numbers and addresses, all stating they're hazardous waste. So okay, my
it
research,
may not all be commercial scale, some
they
are.
Okay. Here they are. And there, I have the website and all the information. So the information he's given you is not correct because I did my own and here it is, there's 22. So you can see we are already...
Well, that makes it worse.
It does make it worse, but I just want you to see that we're doing our own research here and we're turning the information over to the solicitor as we get it. Thirdly,
thank you.
The budget, you're welcome. There are a lot of people in this room that do not reside in this township, right? So this problem is far greater than the New Milford Township. Unfortunately, by default, because the property sits in the township, we're fitting the bill. And our legal fees in just 2.5 weeks' time are already at $850. Why did we pony up more money to pay him when you guys contacted him? We didn't. We have a solicitor. When all is said and done, we're going to have to pay that bill. We're not going to pay two.
And your solicitor doesn't know how to draft the ordinance that I drafted.
Absolutely. He's drafted other ordinances for us. So if they want to give us information that you have, you're welcome to share it with us. Our solicitor will take a look at it.
I'll guarantee you that I'm more expert in this area than your solicitor is. And I'm not trying to get in argument with your solicitor, but this is very specialized. You didn't hire me.
Right.
And this is a very specialized area of law. And this is why I've been brought in to help with this.
I understand.
I'm glad that you're printing stuff off my website and that you have information from a source I don't know that may be correct, although I'm going off EPA's data that says 10. So let's share information. Let's work together if you're actually wanting to be cooperative about it. If you want to be combative about it, you're going to have a whole community that was ready to combat you.
Certainly. I'm just speaking to the budget at this point in time. We have to turn over to our solicitor first and find out what is...
How many people here from New Milford? Can we ask that question?
Sure.
A lot of us are.
But a lot of people who signed up to speak are not, and it wasn't about you not being a resident, it was about me acknowledging the problem is far greater than the township.
Yes,
the wind blows.
Just wanted to make sure.
Right? So where are the other township supervisors? Why aren't they putting in any footwork and groundwork is what I'm saying.
Because it's in your footprint and you're the ones that have the power to do something.
I understand that. I was just strictly talking about the budget at this time, not the incinerator.
So can I ask you a question?
Sure. Your name. I didn't catch your name the first time.
Ruth Rawls.
I'm sorry?
Ruth Rawls.
Okay.
You know, I was wondering, why can't they work in conjunction with the other solicitors, since this young man is an expert? And, of course, we know you have good legal representation. So, and he's an attorney. So why can't they work together, working together?
I think they could, but I think we need to allow our solicitor time to review all the information.
What's the, can I ask you another question?
Sure.
What's his name?
Mike Brickley.
Who?
Michael Brickley.
And did Mike say that he can formulate an ordinance, an air ordinance?
We didn't speak specifically about an air ordinance, but he has drawn up other ordinances for us. And until we give him the information to review, we don't know. And maybe he cannot, and he'll tell us.
What type of ordinances did he recommend?
With regards to this specific?
Yes.
nothing as of yet, because we've still been collecting information, as you can see, doing research, talking to people, because we don't know.
I hate to see what just happened. You guys are sitting up there, and it sounds like we're attacking you when you listen to people. And that's happening. And you are doing a good job. Now, you say you're just addressing somebody who made a comment. Let's pay him. Say that. Say, no, we're not going to, and we don't have any money. You got combative with him. Let's work together and get this done with anybody that can help us.
She specifically referred to the budget. I know that
I
someone...
I understand that.
Someone
it's
has...
It's a state issue now. You said you can't do it. We're not going to do
no,
it.
No, I didn't,
you're
say,
not asking for.
I didn't say we couldn't do it. No. So we have to turn it over to our solicitor first. It's a very realistic possibility they could work together. But until he reviews all the information, we don't know.
I understand. That's what you're saying. What you're sounding like is... He's not even worth anything right now. Our solicitors, let's work together.
Now.
That's what it sounded like to me. You're not saying that beautiful.
I have a quick question. What do we receive as a township for natural gas impact fees? Quarterly? Because I would say that this is directly correlated to natural gas development. So I think that we should use that money to fund a study, number one.
Well,
and number two,
certain things that it can be used for.
Right here. Okay. There's 13 categories.
Okay.
We have to check with our solicitor.
Because $800, as far as I'm concerned, I mean...
But that's,
I think that's
in 10 days. That's in 10 days. See how this thing is going to go on? That's in 10 days. But here's the 13 categories. And the last one says for local or regional planning initiatives.
Okay.
And then for that particular item, there's 103 pages worth of information. So until we make sure legally we can use that money for it, because when they come back and audit us, the only person sitting behind that desk is this person.
Well, let's look into it and see if it's...
And that's why
I know that that number is more, is hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we can afford legal counsel to understand the situation that we're in. And I also have to say this, whether or not there's an incinerator offered to us, we should be writing our ordinances to not have one anyway. Because we don't want one.
That's right. 10 years from now, somebody might else.
Thank you.
That's what I need to worry about.
Could I just say something, please? Let's not let this fall apart over this. We're here to not have an incinerator. And ultimately, that's what our message is, that we want to hear from you when it comes to dealing with Tyler Corners Group and whoever, is that we in Milford Township and the local areas around it do not want an incinerator here, and we have valid, numerous reasons why we don't, as you have so well provided for us. And I, you know, before all of this started, I had a note down here is to thank the group that has brought this to our knowledge to bring in Mr. Ewall. How we compensate him, I think, should be held for another discussion. Some committees may be put together, whether to put committees together for drafting an ordinance or organizing how we're going to do this and stay focused on why we're here.
Right.
And final comment, how do we give you that authority? You know, and that's what it really comes down to. How do we give you the authority to keep this from happening?
We are the town. We have to stay on top of it. What you've given us and what we're getting, if you have some contact information, once we talk to our attorney, it'll be more than he might not even have anything on this. You know what I mean?
Let's work together. I mean, that's
right.
Cindy, I interrupted you. It's your turn to speak.
Oh, I didn't realize. I just was wondering, you never answered my question, sir. I do appreciate being brought up to speed on something that may happen, but Mr. Ewall hasn't said, are you an attorney? Are you an environmentalist? What kind of expertise are you bringing other than things you're bringing off a website from EPA? Have you actually, you know, you're talking about all these places, but I don't. What does your group know about you, and how did we find you? I'm kind of curious, because we've been stonewalled before in a small county with some fancy-talking environmentalists. It didn't turn out to be tree huggers at all. So I am very curious as to...
I'm as skeptical as you are.
Seriously, who are you financed by? What, we got pony up money for...
Get no money from the government, no money from corporations. We hardly have any money, period. Do most of this volunteer.
Your energy justice.
Excuse me?
What is energy justice?
It's a nonprofit environmental justice support group that I founded in 1999. It wasn't incorporated until several years later. We exist to help communities fight off dirty energy and waste facilities like this. Hugh Combs may remember me from the 90s, from when Rescue was around, and we were helping, I was one of the leaders around the state helping stop a multi-state nuclear waste dump that Rescue was involved in fighting. And I remember folks from back then.
What are your credentials? You seem to dance around your question.
My credentials?
Yes, sir.
I'm a geologist,
biologist.
I have a sociology degree from Penn State with a minor in science, technology, and society. I have a law degree, and I have my own brain that works very well in 26 years of nonstop fighting dirty industries and studying the science around them, learning from scientists.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Down your degrees again. Give him another 2 minutes.
I have a BS in sociology from Penn State University, a minor in science, technology, and society, and a law degree from UDC, University of the District of Columbia. And I often get mistaken for being a chemist because I've taught myself quite a bit from chemists like Dr. Paul Conant, who was on a video yesterday, and I think Hugh mentioned him earlier. I have deep knowledge on a wide range of this. I don't need the letters after my name for all.
Can I just add one short thing, if you don't mind?
Sure.
I'm going to apologize for any inferred tone that I might have made, because we are all here to cooperate. And, you know, people get upset, people get nervous, people get hotter under the collar. And I think the surrounding communities, the surrounding townships, are woefully underinformed on exactly how large the impact area is, because, you know, we're 50-mile radius around the particles, if I remember correctly from last night's presentation.
I didn't say that because I don't know what the distance would be on that.
Well, as the wind blows. So I'm wondering why people from Scranton aren't here, people from Binghamton aren't here. So I appreciate the fact that when you're dealing with large companies in a rural area, they're going to try and come in with a steamroller.
Money talk.
So, yeah, you're, $850 is an issue, but they're going to come in and try and bankrupt the township. Yeah. And that's what we have to try and dip in the bud. And back them up. So thank you very much for another opportunity.
Thank you. I agree with you 100%.
Yeah.
No different than every township being here. I feel that you should be behind us, not coming at us.
I'm with you. We're looking for all the help we can get.
We're all in this together. Like I said, right. We're all residents here. So.
As a matter of fact, I'm only one of the three supervisors, but I'd be happy to fork over some money. So, you know, you can put me down.
It's not even money. It's going out there and getting the information. That's, just like Joe said, I work every day just like the rest of you.
Yeah.
And we try. We really do.
Well, I'll give you all the credit.
That's why it's important that we utilize our natural gas impact fee money to hire professionals to represent us right now. If it's not allocated in those 102 pages, I understand, but I don't know if that's not allocated.
Right.
And I think that, just like you said, you're out there working, so are we. But we need to have professional representation. We need to have it done now, and we need to really get serious.
I agree.
Young lady,
thank you
again for having us here and listening to our concerns. A lot of semantics has been put around as to what we keep hearing. We don't know what kind, we don't know what's being burned. Whatever. I think from the general gist of everyone's passion here tonight, we don't want garbage. We don't want any kind of incinerator of any kind, no matter what it is they're proposing.
Right.
Am I correct?
That's it. Right.
Incinerators, but hasn't been said anything about, is that 492 has the water for that feeds in New Milford. Is that correct? Up on 492, we have a water supply.
Water supply you're talking about?
Yeah. That has not even been brought up tonight. And that would be in the circumference of, you know, the plant that they want to build, which would go to our water. So, you know, this is going to affect everyone's lives.
I think the borough is kind of aware of what's going on, but...
I'll find out tomorrow night.
I can check out.
When I get...
Yeah, well, if you find something out, you know, you...
I know, we have to do that.
Think about the information again.
Yeah, I'd like to point out something to you, too. I heard it mentioned earlier that you don't live in the township. And I do live on Hartford Road, right near Tyler Road. I could walk to the sign that says New Milford Township from my house. Does that mean you're going to keep your debris in your township? Because I only live less than a mile and a half from the line.
Actually, what I said was a lot of people that are concerned don't live in the township, so we acknowledge the problem is far greater than the township.
Right.
So I wasn't saying that.
Okay. I appreciate that. Okay. But at the same time, there's a dairy farm below me, and you all know where it is. It's on Hartford Road, down below Oliver Road, and above the fairgrounds. Everybody has to know Caldwell's.
Yeah.
And
that's what you're talking about.
And if this debris drifts over and lands on his grass and his cows are eating it, would you drink the milk? I don't think I would. But that's just one. I'm not familiar with where all the farms are, but I'm sure they're even 10 miles away is going to have to worry about what's happening in this area.
Yeah. Yeah. What all the schools we have here.
Right.
Hang on, you had a lot of time to talk and you're not. So is there anybody else that has not yet spoke that has something they want to add or ask?
I'd like to say...
Can you, your name, hon?
Susan Pivitone. This gentleman is a township supervisor and he came on his own free will. Now you said the other townships are not here. My question is, and I understand, you know, this is an issue that has been dropped on you. My question is, have you reached out to any other township and asked for their support? Let's not criticize and say they're not here. The question is, have you reached out? Because he's got 30 years experience and he came on his own. So have you reached out to other townships and said, hey, this may be falling on our lap, but like it's been noted, where they're putting the incinerator, within 10, 15 miles, we're not talking very far, you have Blue Ridge, Montrose, Susquehanna. You have all five major school districts that are pretty much huddled right around each other. So you're talking about our children. So we are not only affecting New Milford Township, but the other townships. So have you reached out to the other townships to maybe help with this? Or again, we're here because we're concerned, but we all need to work together for a solution. So you tell us what you need us to do, and I'm sure the people of this community are going to get together and give you whatever resources you need, whatever support you need to get this done correctly, immediately, and before it's too late. So you need to tell us what needs to be done.
Expect it to take for your solicitor to review the ordinance and get back? Is that going to be a long delay? We need to work quickly.
I know he's on vacation this week, but I'll
get right on with the funding. Oh, great. You know what? I knew you work with us.
Yeah.
I did.
I appreciate that.
Anybody else got anything?
One thing, that was a wonderful comment, Jack. All this thing that's going around, you're going to move forward if you said so.
Yes.
That's the greatest thing we can hear.
Thank you.
That's what we're hearing. cleaning out, you don't know this, there's 22, and I'm not picking on you, we're all human. You seem real proud when you showed that he didn't know what he knew.
I'm just saying,
that's not what we're trying to do.
I'm not trying to be proud, I'm just trying to say, I'm on top of it, I'm doing the research.
Please don't take me for what I'm saying, because that blew that out of proportion, you know? And then the thing came up about the money, he didn't ask for money. Let's not get the job done. Thank you, Jack.
We don't want to know what, how we can or what's going to hold it up.
I was watching, my name is Bob Horst.
Excuse me.
I was watching this Channel 16 news at noon today, and it kind of highlighted some of the things that we heard last night and so on, industrial accidents, things happen, okay? And there's a particular person that was just fined $43,000 for an oil spill in one of the creeks or streams in the Lackawanna Valley, in Lackawanna County. This person's also a player in the Keystone landfill, and also, I understand, a player in this thing that's coming our, that's trying to come our way.
He's one of the four owners of the Tunnel Hill Group that will be moving waste by rail through here. And you can go on their webpage and peel through three layers, and you'll get to the four principal partners of the Tunnel Hill Group.
Well, we're talking industrial accidents, which can happen, you know, in the Milford Township. It just dumped oil out of a
big tank. Do you have a specific, what's the website? Who was saying there's a website?
Tunnel Hill. Tunnel Hill Group.
Is it tunnelhillgroup.com or?
Just punch in Tunnel Hill Group.
And who was the person mentioned, the specific person? Do you have a name?
It's on, yes. Everybody knows who he is.
Can you say the name for the public?
I'd rather not. Louis de Naples. I will affirm that by my silence. And according to their website and the DEP, they are not currently licensed to haul hazardous waste. And that would be, I'm thinking, the reason that they met this week with the DEP in Pennsylvania.
It's Tunnel Hill Partners. Largest waste by rail company in the U.S.
Thank you. I think to carry off what Susan said, I think it's important not just for us to put it on you to call the local townships, but for us to call the townships. I'm about a half mile from the New Milford Township border, but I live in Bridgewater Township. I teach at the school right up the road, and this community is important to me, my children, and all the people that we're all affected. You know, we're all affected by this. So I think that, you know, those of us that live outside of this township, yes, we're here, we also need to pick up the phone and call our township representatives and get them working with you, not just you putting it on them.
Very, very good.
Agreed.
Yeah, there's a question. If other townships, other municipalities get their own air ordinances, can those air ordinances also apply to neighboring townships that they can't?
They only apply to their borders.
I mean, as far as getting pollution from neighboring townships. For instance, if Gibson and Hartford had this and New Milford allowed this to be built, can Gibson and Hartford sue New Milford Township if they have an ordinance in place protecting their air from? They can't do that. Okay. So it's not going to help.
It's got to be where
in
the
this
source
case,
is.
Has to be where the facility will be.
So it can't help in this case with this property.
Unless they go after those other townships.
It so tells us where
preemptively get them in other townships.
Right.
That's not
I have a question, maybe related or other. Here's a problem. They were talking about Amtrak going to Manhattan and a train station being in the Milford. And quickly, you know, everybody was, I think, was lying about it. And it was all about freight and DNS quarries was going to have this whole big thing. And we were directly lied to. Shortly after that, we got a transfer station put in. And I'm wondering, well, this is connected. Why did New Milford push and the transfer station put in? The railroad didn't even know.
I can address a couple of things.
As I say, can't you?
One of the other volunteer hats I wear is a trailer rail authority. The transfer station was talked about 10 years ago being put by the Susquehanna County Railroad Authority, and that never came to fruition. It had nothing to do with, wait, we never talked.
Is this coincidence?
It was just coincidence. Purely just coincidence. And as regards to the...
So now it was never about freight?
Well, no, it was a big freight transload facility. The Amtrak thing was a totally different study based on the pickups and transportation, which we attended the meeting. But that was a completely separate of the passenger piece versus the rail.
It's just a situation that's happening together.
Two things happening at the same time.
And it just kind of...
Right. But also, since the rail was raised, I also checked today with Milford and Incinerators, and they know nothing about any way hauling any kind of waste. Nor do we in the rail guard of the county.
Can I add something?
Yes, I'm from another township. I'm from Harper Township. And I wondered if our township, in fact, our supervisor called us this morning, that's why we're here. If they want to work with you, do you want them to call you, or do you want to call? Because I know you're going to be...
They can call and set something up. We'll be more than happy to...
Okay.
All hands needed.
We'll have them call you, because they're already concerned.
Okay. Fine. Anybody else?
One thing that was mentioned
Happy birthday.
Last night was that a man in Ohio in the hazardous waste incinerator there worked diligently to stop that incinerator, and he lost. Years later now, I'm not sure how many, Mike, there's all kinds of cancers there. Men's breast cancer, very unusual cancers, higher than any national or state normally would be. And he suggested to one of the people here, I'm not sure who, that we have a baseline. Is that what we're looking for? A baseline health study and air quality study. Is that correct?
That's what he recommended.
That's one of the things he recommended. I'm not sure
Can I address that? That's only really necessary if it gets to the permit stage. And because really it's the DEP who's going to have to do that. We're kind of hoping to keep it from getting to that stage.
Okay. Last question.
Yes, I'm Brett Jennings. I'm from the Halstead Great Management Sewer Authority. I've seen before that you were updating your 537 plan for sewage. Is there any way a copy could get sent to Dorothy at the authority when that gets done?
Is it us or is it the borough?
You sure it's not the borough?
Oh, the township's not updating it.
Township. You better check with the borough, because I think...
No, but this is for... I know the old one had Pages Lake actually hooking into the sewer. I don't know if it's being updated, if that's getting changed.
So they're not to my knowledge. Our act there is 537. They're not being...
Okay.
I mean, we can check into it.
Okay, because I thought the township was actually updating it.
We talked about it 12 years ago. Yeah. Maybe you can check into it. Let him know. Anybody else? This time I make a motion to adjourn the meeting and pay the bills.
Wait. I just have one non-incinerator question. It's about the CNG filling station.
I gave you extra time last time,
right? She wouldn't even let me put my name in this time. I just want to know. We did not cover it last night. Where exactly is the CNG filling station planned to be on 493? I don't know
where the old Milford Manor used to be.
Is it before or after East Lake Road? Is it before?
After East Lake Road.
Is it and it's before Hall Road, so it's right where CPP-1A is, basically?
Before.
Is it on the east or the west side?
Right next to 81.
It's where the yellow backhoe is sitting in the driveway. On the right-hand side before you get on the...
Is that on the right or the left?
Going towards my house.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
On the dip.
Right.
Before you go down the dip.
Thank you.